From a platform perspective, there are much more closed platforms than PC platforms. You can't just randomly install any application you want. It has to go through some sort of app store on these devices, and in the case of Apple, a very rigidly controlled app store. So the ability to actually deliver code to that platform is very, very limited. So as a result, what we're seeing is that in the wild, there's actually not that many threats that have been seen hitting those platforms, particularly for Apple. And that's really been an interesting thing to watch, sort of the correlation of threats on the iOS platform versus the Google platform. The Google platform, obviously, wide open, can connect to any app store, fairly easy to get an application into the Google Play Marketplace, versus Apple, very, very restrictive, and anyone who's gone through the process of actually getting a certificate from Apple to allow you to submit an application to the iOS store can tell you that they pretty much want your DNA, family history. And that really creates a very good deterrent effect, because ultimately, even though both Apple and Google invest a lot of efforts in scanning applications for security vulnerabilities and for nefarious use, ultimately something can get through. And the idea that you can actually track it back to the original submitter and have so much information on them, if it's a business, they're asking for incorporation records, for a lot of the business information. If you're an individual, they want your driver's license, literally, and a lot of other information, so that they can actually track you down and find you if you did submit a piece of malware into the system and lock you from being able to submit in the future. And it works actually very well. There have been only a handful of cases in recent years where we've seen malicious applications submitted through the iOS platform, and mostly by researchers that wanted to kind of play around and as a result got banned by Apple. So nothing that was truly significantly malicious made it through. And the Google Play marketplace, you've only had, I think, about 24 applications that have gone through and actually been delivered to devices, and they were yanked within something like 24 or 48 hours by Google. So the ability to remediate the device remotely is also a great capability that you can leverage on these platforms. The other good news is that the platforms are generally very heterogeneous. So you do not have the monopoly that exists on the PC platform, although it's eroding now, but primarily, you know, it's a Windows-based ecosystem. So being able to develop one exploit, you're confident that it's going to work across all the different Windows platforms, whether it's Windows XP or Windows 7 or tablet, PC, desktop, laptop, doesn't matter, right? So as a malicious user, you know that if you invest enough resources in developing that great exploit, you can deliver it to literally billions of users that are using that platform. In the mobile ecosystem, it's very, very different. So the Apple ecosystem is actually obviously a little more aligned with that, because most Apple phones are the same and code reuse there is possible. But in terms of Android, which is, you know, depending on stats, some like 70 or 80% of the market, every phone is different, right? The firmware is different. The device itself is different. You may have different processors on them. The Android version is different. So as a malicious user, or even as a legitimate developer, you really have the nightmare scenario of actually trying to test your applications, whether they're malicious or legitimate, across all these different platforms if you want to have broad effect, which significantly limits your return on investment. Now, obviously, that can only go so far. So, you know, if you're an enterprise and cyber criminal, you want to target sort of the most popular phones, and you can pick sort of the three or four targets that you're interested in, and that's probably going to be a significant chunk of the market for you that's going to be sufficient. So that only goes about so far.